starring June Lockhart, Hugh Riley, John Provost as Timmy, and, of course, Lassie.
So now I've trained this one, Cicero, to sit up whenever I tell him to. Go ahead, Cicero, sit up. Well, almost whenever I tell him to.
Well, maybe he's bashful in front of people.
What's the matter with you, Cicero?
Now, who else has some experience he or she would like to share with the class? Wilhelmina.
I have an experience, Miss Hazlitt.
Good. Why don't you come up and tell us about it?
Last week I told about Melody, my goose. But this time I want to tell about my new petticoat. It's made of real taffeta, so it swishes when I walk. And the material costs $3.70 a yard. And the lace was some more besides that.
Oh, it is lovely, Wilhelmina. And wasn't it nice of your mother to stay up and finish it so you could wear it to the party?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, thank you, Wilhelmina.
Timmy?
Yes, Miss Hazlitt?
I've heard some pretty wonderful things about your pet.
You mean Lassie?
Wouldn't you like to share some of the experiences you've had with Lassie?
Well, Lassie's my dog.
Haven't you and she had some adventures together?
Well, she's done a lot of smart things.
You think of something you can tell us about next week at sharing period.
Yes, ma'am. Here it is Saturday, Lassie. And you haven't done an interesting thing all week. I don't think that's what Miss Hazlitt meant.
Teaching Lassie some new tricks?
No, Uncle Petrie. Lassie's supposed to have an experience this week.
How's that again?
Well, you see, Miss Hazlitt said Lassie was supposed to have an interesting experience this week. So I can tell about it in sharing period, Monday. And here it is Saturday. And Lassie hasn't done anything all week.
Well, now, if anyone was to ask me, I'd say Lassie's had more interest and experiences than any dog in this county. Ain't that right, Lassie? That's telling them. Well, I'll be switched. Termites.
Hi, Boomer.
Hi. My mom said she'd bake a pie if I picked the berries. You want to go along?
Sure. Maybe my mom will bake one, too.
Don't forget now, only the ripe ones.
Okay, we won't.
Now, what was that all about?
We're going to have fresh berry pie for dessert tomorrow night.
Suits me. Have you seen Paul?
Yes, he's fixing that fence so we won't have to worry about the stock while we're at church tomorrow.
You're probably the best berry scout in the whole world, I bet.
Oh, boy. Why can't you find berry bushes like this?
Here comes Roy.
What are you guys doing? Picking berries?
Our moms are gonna make berry pies.
What are you doing?
Catching butterflies.
What are you doing that for?
It's an experience, so I have something to talk about in sharing period. What are you going to talk about? Picking berries isn't much of an experience.
I'm gonna have something better than that.
I'll bet. Like Boomer's mice, sit up, Cicero.
Well, he was bashful. Miss Hazlitt even said so. What you got in the bottle? It's got ether in it. That's how you kill 'em.
Kill 'em?
Sure. You can't very well mount them on a board if they're still alive.
You're always talking about what you're gonna do, Roy. How many butterflies have you caught?
Well, none so far, but I just started. See you guys. Don't take any green berries.
Why does he have to kill them?
Don't worry, Timmy. He probably won't catch any. I think the butterflies are smarter than he is.
It's a good thing you saw it. That beam is the main support of the roof.
I thought it looked a mite suspicious, so I took a closer look, and sure enough, termites.
First thing we got to do is shore up that roof. Don't we have a 4x4 around here?
Yeah, we had one left over when we reinforced the loft. I think I know right where it is.
I'll tell you what we better do, Uncle Petrie. First thing we've got to do is get a temporary support up. Then you can check the rest of the beams for termites while I finish the chores.
Seems to me, Lassie being a Bear Scout would make a pretty good experience.
It's all right, I guess. But what could we say after we said we went berry picking and Lassie found all the bushes?
Not much, I guess. You ought to get Roy to chat. He could make a good story.
You know what we ought to do? Go through the woods and chase all the butterflies away and save their lives.
What's Lassie doing?
She's gonna fish! Catching a fish with a pole. It's like catching a fish for a pet.
For a pet?
He'll be Lassie's pet. And we'll name him Speckles. How about it, Lassie? How's that for an interesting experience?
There she be.
You sure it's safe?
Take my word for it, Ruth. She's sound as a dollar.
But it's just resting on the ground.
Well, honey, the weight of the roof will keep it from slipping.
The only thing will make that slip will be a flood, and we just don't get very many of them anymore.
Well, all right, if you say so.
Check the rest of the barn. So far, the little critters have only started on one other timber. Haven't had time to do much damage.
We'll get something on Monday and treat the whole barn.
Mom, where's Dad?
Well, he's in the barn, but he'll be coming in the house in a minute.
He's in the barn. Come on.
Oh, wait a minute. Timmy, I don't think you ought to... Timmy, what's the meaning of this?
I hear you have a real live trout in your sink.
His name's Speckles. If we can keep him for Lassie's pet, it'll be a real interesting experience. And I can tell a better story of sharing period than Roy can.
What's all this about sharing period?
Oh, well, every Monday morning, the children are supposed to tell what they've done over the weekend or through the week. It's a sharing of experiences.
But he's never had a pet like Lassie, and I'll be able to beat him this time.
Look, Timmy, it's just impossible to keep a game fish on a farm. He's got to have running water to breathe in. He's too big for the sink, and you can't keep him in the trough because it's too shallow. He'll get sunburned.
Sunburned?
Sure, fish can get sunburned.
I think maybe it's worth the trouble, Uncle Petrie.
What? How in thunder can it be worth all that trouble?
Why, so Timmy can be... So Timmy will have an interesting experience to share at school.
Well, all right, Paul. On one condition, though. Speckles can't take up permanent residence in my kitchen sink.
Gee, Lassie, I bet you're the only pet in the whole world that has a pet of her own.
What's that for, Mr. Martin?
A boomer. Fish have to breathe, same as humans do.
How can they breathe underwater, Dad? I tried it once and I couldn't.
That's because you don't have gills.
Gills?
Sure. You see those little slits on either side of Speckles' neck? Well, those are called gill slits. You see, when Speckles swims, he sucks water into his mouth and pushes it out through those slits. Now, ahead of the slits are the gills, and they take oxygen out of the water just as our lungs take it out of the air.
Oh.
So we've got to see that Speckles has plenty of fresh water to breathe. Boomer.
Yes, sir?
Will you go out in the yard, and when I call, turn the water on?
Yes, sir.
Turn it very slowly, Boomer. And when I give the signal, stop.
Okay. Come on, Mike.
Well, look, son. I'm going to show you something else. Now watch. I'm going to fill this hose. All right, Boomer. That's good.
What are you doing that for?
Look. That's called siphoning, Timmy. As long as that end of the hose is lower than the water level in the tub, it'll continue to drain out.
Gee, Dad, did you invent siphoning?
Not quite, but I've known about it for some time. Now, Lassie's done her part, and I've done my part. Now we've got to find some food for Speckles.
Okay, that'll be my part. I know, minnows and insects.
Right.
Come on, Lassie.
God bless Mom and Dad, and God bless Uncle Petrie, and God bless Lassie. And that means God bless my pet Speckles, sir. Amen.
All right, now, Timmy, you'll go right to sleep, won't you?
Night, Mom.
Good night, dear. See you in the morning.
Night, son.
Night, Dad.
Lassie.
It was, Paul.
Well, there's been some signs of a fisher lately trying to get at the chickens. Might be he was sidetracked by the smell of trout.
Nobody needs me. I'm going back to bed.
I'm almost through. Thanks anyway, Uncle Petrie.
If anyone was to ask me, I'd say this is a lot of foolishness. A trout like that belongs in a lake. Or in a frying pan.
Uncle Petrie thinks Speckles is too much trouble to keep, doesn't he?
Oh, it isn't that, Timmy. I think he probably feels that Speckles isn't happy all cooped up like that when he's accustomed to having a big lake to swim in.
Anyway, Speckles has his house back, and it's time we all went to bed.
Dad, will a fisher come back?
Well, I can't guarantee that he won't.
Lassie, you stay here and don't let anything happen to Speckles. I don't think he'd be very happy in a frying pan either.
Come on, honey.
Good night, girl. I'll be right with you, Lassie. Lassie, come back, girl. You're a good girl, Lassie. I think we've seen the last of Mr. Fisher tonight.
I hope so. You go on, run back to Speckles.
Everything's all right now, Lassie. You go on into the barn. Why not try the door?
Lassie won't let me in to see Speckles.
What is it, girl? Something wrong with Speckles? Beam we put up slipped and fell.
Gee, Dad, I guess Lassie's smarter than both of us.
Huh. Thanks, Lassie. Thanks more than I can tell you.
Then the beam fell down with an awful crash. And if Lassie hadn't growled at us... Show them how you growled at us, Lassie. And if she hadn't growled at us like that, we'd have all gone in the barn and probably all have been killed, or at least hurt pretty bad.
Well, that's a truly remarkable experience, Timmy. You left out only one thing. Where is Speckles now?
Me and Lassie, I mean Lassie and I, we thought it wouldn't be very nice to keep Speckles all cooped up like that, so we took him back home.
Oh, back to the lake?
No, ma'am. We took him to the river. I don't think Lassie would like it very much if Speckles got caught with a fishing pole.
Oh, I see. Well, I think that's one of the most exciting experiences we've had all year. And Lassie, I'm inclined to agree with your master. You're probably the smartest dog in this whole wide world.